If you start preparing for NEET even today, assuming that you are an average 50 to 70% student, what do you think is the possibility that you cross 580 or 600 marks in the NEET examination in the next 20 days? If you ask me, I'll say there is every possibility. If you follow structure, if you follow focus, if you follow discipline, then you're on the right path and now you can improve and increase speed. Getting good marks in NEET is a matter of strategy. It's not emotion where you sit for long hours and end up doing anything. It's about doing the right thing, the right way, in the right fashion, for the right amount of time. And anything which is not repeated is negative. It's not going to give you what you really desire. My question to you is, agar aapne aaj ek full-length paper leke solve kiya, kitna milega? How much will you get if you solve a full-length paper? Would you get 300 or would you get 250? Itna to milega hi na. If you don't get this much also, then what's the point you're giving NEET? If you're currently at 300, I have a strategy with which you can get 600 in this examination. Very simple strategy. Students have been asking me this on Instagram and I have been replying to this and I'm going to reply that over here as well. Haven't you asked me this on Instagram and haven't you got this reply? Well, if you listen to the interview which Mr. Joshi gave, the chairperson of the NTA, he spoke of three things. And I'm extremely glad that he came and spoke, and he spoke exactly what we've been telling on this channel. And I'm happy for those children who've been following this the way it's been told. He first said, solve mock papers. We've been talking about this. Second, he said focus is important. I would add to it by saying that focus, determination, direction, beating complacency in every way is important. And here's the big one that Mr. Joshi said. He said, NCERT ke bahar kuch nahi aayega. Isn't that amazing? So children who've been focusing and working hard on the NCERT curriculum, bingo, bang on, you are there. So I'm saying the next 60 days, if you pick up one full-length paper and solve, what will happen? Even if in every paper you're getting 1% more than the previous paper, haven't you done great for yourself? Now, let's say you're getting currently 300 marks. If you're getting 300 marks out of 720, all that means is you are somewhere around 30 out of 90 in biology, 15 ke aaspaas in chemistry, and 10-15 ke aaspaas in physics. That's what it actually means, right? Now, if you're solving one paper every day, and if you're solving 60 papers in 60 days, wouldn't you reach 80 out of 90 questions in biology? Wouldn't you reach 38 to 40 out of 45 in chemistry? And let's say you don't reach that. Let's say you reach 35. Still good, right? And let's say you reach 30, 32 in physics. Wouldn't that happen? And to do this, I'm telling you, take 3 hours every day and solve a paper and solve it really well, diligently, full focus ke saath, full hard work ke saath. Sometimes when you're going through hell, keep going is what I will say. Keep going, because that's the only way you can succeed. Now, once you start doing one paper every day, you're putting 3 hours, your investment on a daily basis, 3 hours, systematic, daily, consistent, rhythmic practice. Now use 4 hours every day to see what mistakes you did, to study those mistakes, to rectify those mistakes, and to decide tomorrow which paper you will solve. And take another 90 minutes every day. And in this 90 minutes, what I want you to do is very simple. I want you to solve only physics. See, biology is easy, and I know you will score good in biology. Now, the war is between physics and chemistry. How to increase the 30 to 40 or 42 in chemistry, and how to go about 25 in physics. That's if you want 600. 600 is an important benchmark, and I think you should work very hard towards getting that. Now, once you solve this, I'm telling you, 3 hours solving the paper, 4 hours self-study, and one and a half hour studying physics. So this makes it 8.5 hours, right? This 8.5 hours is what you have to give towards self-study. If you do not give time for self-study, what's the whole point? If you look at the new course that we have launched on Meritstore, you will realize it is revising NEET in 30 days. We've come out with a systematic course. That's exactly the way I'm telling you how you should practice how you should study. If you look at the course, you'll realize it's only going to complement you. It's only going to supplement you. The teacher takes a paper, solves the paper. You can listen to the paper, go with the paper, and practice that. And I'm telling you, if you solve 60 papers in the next 60 days, what are the chances that you will get less than 600? Tell me, what are the chances you will get less than 600? Coaching classes, tuition centers, sab theek hai. But if you do not invest time on self-study, it's all going to be wasted. So once you solve the paper, you will know kya nahi aata hai. You will know kaha galti ho raha hai. Sit and study that. Do a lot of self-study, introspection, checking, going back and forth, the NCRT, the MCQs, etc. Iske bawajood bhi agar samajh mein nahi aata hai, that's when you go to a teacher and say, sir, mujhe SN1 reaction nahi aata hai. Sir, mujhe electromagnetic induction mein ye problem hai. Madam, mujhe yahan par ye problem hai. Go tell them. But otherwise, if you're going to sit for 6 hours lectures, 8 hours lecture in a coaching class, in a tuition center, what good use is that if you're not going to come back and invest that on self-study? I'm not against that, but I'm saying if you're going to sit 6 hours there, kuch bhi kar lo. There is no substitute for self-study of that 4.5, 5.5, 6.5, 7.5, 8.5 hours a day. That's based on your stamina and that's based on what you really want. Remember, the trick is to get more in biology and to come up in physics a little more. See, everybody is going to score in biology and chemistry. And every student I speak to, whether it's Instagram or it's YouTube, they're saying physics is hard and we're going to lose a little more in physics. But that's okay, we are working hard for something else. But I'm saying physics is your deciding point. If you're not going to work in alignment with physics, what's the whole point? So I'm going to wish you luck here. I'm going to say visit the Merit Store and see whether that course is helpful to you and how you're going to compile that with your daily study plan. Go through it systematically. Solve 60 papers.